Good morning, New Hope. Great to be with you today again for another Daily Hope. I hope you're doing well. Today, we're going to spend some time in Galatians chapter 5, and we're going to be talking about this learning to discern God's voice or God's character compared to others. And I was remembering a few years back that I went to a training, and the person that was leading the training, he brought a whiteboard in front of the group, and he divided it in two, and on one side he put, you know, God's character, the Holy Spirit, Jesus, what they're about, and then on the other side he put the world, the flesh, and the devil, and what they're about. And it was amazing to me. It's just this image in my mind now forever, I think, just of how clear it is, the difference between God and between the world, the flesh, and the devil. And Galatians 5 talks all about this, right? Verse 19, it says this: the works of the flesh are obvious. Sexual immorality, impurity, sensuality, idolatry, sorcery, enmity, strife, jealousy, fits of anger, rivalries, dissensions, divisions, envy, drunkenness, things like these. So really clear, on the one side you have evil is obvious, but then we also know that God can be obvious too. It says the fruit of the Spirit, if some of you might remember the song even, the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, gentleness, faithfulness, self-control, like things that are very evident of what God's about, and it compares to what the world, the flesh, and the devil's about. And when we try to listen to God's voice, it's a real, when you have that in front of you, you can discern pretty quickly, like which way is which. And I just want to encourage you today to be, if you're looking for God's voice, if you're looking for God's way, if you want to know the difference, if you want to know His way for your life, it's a real clear picture. Galatians chapter 5. And even I'm going to say too that, you know, we know that God's word can teach us a lot about Him, right? It says, even earlier in that chapter, it says, the persuasion that leads to evil, that's not God. So we know that there's a way, and it's right, and it's good, and we can identify it by what it looks like. All right, let's pray together. Lord, we're just so grateful that You give us a clear picture of Your way, compared to the ways of the world, the flesh, and the devil. And I pray that You'd help us today to see, to help us to hear, to help us to listen to Your voice, to learn how to discern Your way in our lives and how we can go Your way, the way that You're leading us. And I pray this in Jesus' name for everyone listening. Amen. All right, be encouraged today, New Hope.